This is for last Sunday. The battle is the Lord. So after the service, try and get one, and the devil will cry in Jesus' name. Let us look at the book of 2 Kings. 2 Kings chapter 6 from verse 1 to 7. 2 Kings. The company of the prophet said to Elisha, "Look, the place where we meet with you is too small for us. Let us go to the Jordan, where each of us can get a pool, and let us build a place there for us to live." And he said, "Go." Then one of them said, "Won't you please come with your servants?" "I will," Elisha replied, and he went with them. They went to the Jordan and began to cut down trees. One of them was cutting down a tree. The iron axe head fell into the water. "Oh my God," he cried out. It was borrowed. The man of God asked, "Where did it fall?" When he showed him the place, Elisha cut a stick and threw it there and made the iron float. "Lift it out," he said. Then the man reached his hands and took it. Is somebody hearing me? This morning, the axe head that you have lost, you are recovering it. Amen. The title of the message this morning is that your axe head is not lost. Somebody talk to your neighbor. Tell him, "My axe head is not lost." Your axe head is what you need to do the job. Is what you need to grease you forward. Is the power you need to move forward. Is the peace you need in your life to rest. The axe head, I said, is the faith in God you need to push through. The axe head is the peace you need in your life to rest. Your axe head, it is your home, the house you need to rest. Your axe head, it is the school, the education you need. The axe head, it is the money you need to push your life through. The axe head, it is the rest you needed for your life. And that is why this morning the enemy thought he has stolen your axe head. The enemy thought that you have missed your axe head. I come as a prophet under the anointing of Elisha this morning to tell somebody, pick your axe head and continue your journey. Pick your axe head and walk in the name of Jesus. The Bible first started that they said to Elisha, they said, "Where we are gathering is too small for us. Let us move and build a new house where we can live." And the Bible says they went and they were cutting the trees. And one of them, whom I think he was working very hard, he was walking and he was not watching. He was walking and he was not careful. The Bible says, and the axe head went off the axe handle and it dropped inside the water, the river Jordan. Is somebody hearing me? It dropped inside the Jordan River. And you know, from chapter 5, Elisha said to Nehemiah, "Go to the Jordan River and bathe yourself 7 times. Dip yourself 7 times. When you come out, you will be what? You will be made whole." And here in chapter 6, a axe head that a man need to walk fell into the same river. God punished the devil. The river that God have created for you to prosper, the enemy want to turn that river to be a curse in your life. No more. I stand this morning as a prophet to tell the enemy, no more will he spoil your water. Your water will be sweet. In the name of Jesus, that river that God have made to flow into your life, the river will flow into your life as a blessing, not a curse. In the name of Jesus, somebody shout yes. So chapter 6, the same river that healed want to turn to be a river that want to deny a man to walk. The axe head is the power you need to what? To walk. Librotoshiata. You can't cut the tree by flailing at the tree with the axe handle. You can't just be flailing the tree with the axe handle. You need the sharp cutting edge, iron edge, to cut down the tree. That is why after this message this morning, every evil tree in your life shall be cut down. Every evil tree in your father's house shall be cut down. I don't care the root, how long the root, how deep the root have entered inside the ground. That
evil tree, you are cutting it, because I am returning the axe head into your hands, and you will cut it down by the power in the name of Jesus. Every evil tree of disappointment, you are cutting it down. Every evil tree of shame, you are cutting it down. Every evil tree of disgrace, you are cutting it down. Every evil tree of sickness, you are cutting it down. Every evil tree of lack, you are cutting it down. The man said, I borrow. Is somebody hearing me? Every evil tree of debt, you are paying it. What makes the man to cry is one thing. Because he borrowed. Look at his cry. He said, "Na borrow, I borrow amu." I don't know, during the time of election, prophet, there's an issue there that I need to go and ask. Why is it that borrow? The Bible says, and a widow came to Elisha and she's crying that her husband, he's among the group of the prophet. And Elisha said, I know him. The woman said, my husband died and the only inheritance he left for my children is the money he borrowed from people. And now they are coming to even carry the children as a collateral. Is somebody hearing me? So, and here is another man who was shining. When the prophet were walking, he was at the front. Because the man was behind, the axe head could have hit somebody. So he was at the forefront. He is the bulldozer. He was cutting the trees, walking tirelessly. He was so strong, walking. He was walking so hard, but he was not walking so carefully. That is why some of you here, you have been walking so hard, but you are not so careful about the people that are around you. The same people you are working hard, and they are praising you that you are working hard, are the same people going behind you to go and pull you down. That is why your axe head, up to now, you can't find it. Some of you have lost it last year. Some of you lost it the day you were born. A witch came and she stole your axe head. That is why you keep on working so hard and there is no result. No result in your work. No result in anything you do. People that don't even know close to you, they are doing well. They are getting result. They are doing small and they are getting result. You are doing much and there is no result. God punish the devil this morning. I said, I recover your axe head by the power in the name of Jesus. I release that grace upon you. That shame that debt is bringing your way will not come. Why? Because you are paying back the debts. In the name of Jesus, you are not born to be a debtor. You are born to be a lender. This morning, receive the grace. This morning, receive the anointing. Receive the oil to pay every debt before the end of this month. Every debt, I don't care how big it is. Receive grace to pay it. In the name of Jesus, your axe head is not lost. I recover it for you. That thing that you used to do and money will come, represent your axe head. I recover it for you. This, when you go out this month, you will do small and you will see result. Why? Because this time around, you are not just doing it the way you used to do it before. You have your axe head in your hands. There is something in your hands that will make oil come into your life. And Elisha asked the woman, what do you have? She said, I have what? Just oil. That is the axe head. Hallelujah. Amen. That is the axe head. And Jesus asked the disciples, these people were gathered waiting they get. He said, now one small boy hold fish and bread. That is the axe head. And God asked Moses, what is in your hands? Moses said, rod. That is the axe head. Is somebody hearing me? That is the axe head. And Pharaoh was looking for who can interpret dream. And the servant said, there is a man called Joseph. He can interpret dreams. That is a axe head. That thing that you can do, that God has put in you, that you can do, while nobody can do it the way you can do it. That is a axe head. This morning, I recover it for you. I said, I recover it for you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. It is an axe head. Hallelujah. Your beauty is an axe head. When you enter, people are supposed to bow. Whether they like it or not, they must bow this month. When you enter, they must bow. I release that grace upon you. They must bow for you. In the name of Jesus. Because you are operating under the real oil of God. Ashabrakata, undiluted oil from heaven. Not these ones they have mixed with all this caricature. Not these ones they have mixed with all this nonsense thing. That is not the oil that is being released upon your life in Grace Prayer Ministry. The oil you are receiving is undiluted oil from the throne of mercy, from the throne of grace. And that oil has been released upon you. This week, you will look so sweet. This week, people must favor you. They must run to you. Why? Because the oil you are receiving is a fresh one. You will always look fresh. Somebody shout, yes, oh!